Okay, this is chapter 4, immune, sulfonamides, fluoroquinolones, and metronidazole, or metronidazole, I've heard it both ways. So the four drugs we're going to use are the first combination drug, sulfamethoxazole with trimethoprim, abbreviated SMZ-TMP, and we'll use that abbreviation throughout, brand Bactrim DS and Ceptra. These are folic acid inhibitors, and the bottom line is that the bacteria needs to make its own folic acid. So if we stop that ability, then we can continue to take in folic acid from food, but the bacteria can't. Then the fluoroquinolones, ciprofloxacin and levofloxacin, brand Cipro and Levoquin respectively. And then the nitroimidazole, which is metronidazole. It's not really an antibiotic, it's an antiprotozole, but we don't need to split hairs. Practice question one. So when I see the drug classes and the drugs themselves, I start thinking immediately about some side effects and things like that. But let's start with our first question. Which drug classes commonly treat a urinary tract infection? Select all that apply. When I think of sulfa drug and the folic acid inhibitor trimethoprim, I immediately think Stevens-Johnson syndrome with the sulfa drug, or drinking a lot of water to make sure you don't get crystallurea, or bilirubin in the brain in young infants. With the trimethoprim, I think of hyperkalemia, struggles to get renal excretion of the potassium. So those are the four that I think of when we're talking about side effects with those drugs. The fluoroquinolone, first thing I think with Cipro is that you have to take twice a day versus Levoquin, which you only have to take once a day. But with both, I immediately think of chelation, that binding that I talked about with the tetracyclines where you have aluminum or magnesium or calcium, and you have these divalent cations where they've got a couple of pluses and they bind to the drug itself, making it inert. I think of photosensitivity, so being out in the sun and burning very easily. And then I think of Achilles tendon rupture, which is a very graphic thing to think of. But this tendon issue has actually caused the FDA to make a change, and I'll go over that a little bit later. And then the nitroimidazole, and I said antibiotic, it's an antiprotozole, but peptic ulcer disease, usually in quad therapy, treatment for Clostridium difficile. And then that odd disulfiram effect where somebody takes in metronidazole and then alcohol at the same time, they're going to possibly have severe nausea and vomiting to the point of projectile vomiting, something like that. So here are the answers. The common drug classes for UTIs are the sulfa folic acid inhibitor combination and then the fluoroquinolones. But let's go to that FDA notice. And I've just highlighted the key points that fluoroquinolones should be reserved when you have an uncomplicated urinary tract infection because of serious side effects, and they outweigh the benefits. Basically saying that where for a long time Cipro and Levo would have been pretty readily dispensed for a urinary tract infection, now I think prescribers are going to be quite a bit more cautious with this FDA mandate that's gone out. But here are the drug names. So what drug classes commonly treated urinary tract infection, or what drugs commonly treated urinary tract infection. So SMZ-TMP, the sulfamethoxazole with trimethoprim, the ciprofloxacin, and then the levofloxacin. But now we're going to be under this new FDA guideline. We're really thinking, okay, that's going to change from the uncomplicated UTI to something that might be complicated, where there's maybe kidney involvement or something like that. Practice question three, make B correct. So which medication might cause Achilles tendon rupture? Or, and what I've done here is that you can, the test makers can ask the same exact question and just replace photosensitivity or chelation for this question. So what medication might cause Achilles tendon rupture or photosensitivity or chelation as an adverse effect? And in this case, you would say ciprofloxacin and levofloxacin. Now, I have seen before that sulfamethoxazole can also cause a bit of photosensitivity, but I've also seen articles to the contrary. So I'm not going to say sulfa drugs for right now. Question four, make C correct. Which medication is once daily dosing? So the sulfa drugs you'll probably use twice a day. Cipro twice a day. Levofloxacin is the one that's once daily dosing, which really makes a difference when you're a patient and you know you're busy. So like a Z-Pak, you only have to take one a day. And then metronidazole, this one's actually every 6 hours, so quite often to take something like this. Which medication is a drug of choice for C. diff? Metronidazole, definitely. Vancomycin, metronidazole, these are, as soon as you hear C. diff, those are the two you want to really think about. And then which medication would be a preferred treatment for peptic ulcer disease? Select all that apply. This is a little bit tricky, where a fluoroquinolone, sure, would work for peptic ulcer disease, but you want to think, okay, well, levofloxacin, it's only taken once a day. That's better than having to take something twice a day. So if given the choice and a preferred treatment, I would prefer levofloxacin over ciprofloxacin, and then metronidazole again, often added as a fourth in quad therapy for peptic ulcer disease. And then which medication can cause a disulfiram-like reaction when a patient takes it with alcohol? Now, disulfiram itself is something that patients that are trying to, who are alcoholics or trying to get off of alcohol, would take so that if they did drink the alcohol, it would make them really sick and they would hopefully remember that experience and not do it again. Now, obviously, the patient can stop taking it. It's kind of similar, I guess, to putting that lacquer on someone's nails when you don't want them to bite their nails and it just tastes so bad, and then they start to remember, oh, I shouldn't be doing that. What happens with metronidazole is that if you take that with alcohol, and really, why is anyone taking an antibiotic with alcohol or an antibacterial and any kind of antibacterial with alcohol? You suppress the immune system a little bit. So this is just one of those unusual, oddball, unique side effects that a lot of the test makers like to test.